Akato Production. Know what it's like laying awake at night with insatiable appetites to make a contribution before you leave to the afterlife. Dealing with the facts of life, always making the sacrifice, only to end up overshadowed by niggas half as nice. It's cancer like every day I say that this can't be right. What makes the curse worse is the listeners are the parasites, feeding off their figment images depicting paradise and glorifying any swag rapper in a new pair of nights. Meanwhile, there's an artist with some content saying something conscious, constantly being labeled as nonsense, all because of his practice habits, not following brackets of the stereotypical demographic. He tries to find time for his rhyming through all the work and stress, writing late nights, running off a couple of purposes, overflowing knowledge, but there's nobody that's heard him yet. It's messing with his nerves, steady increasing his nervousness. But there's a surge with the adjectives and verbs that he slurs that won't allow him to give up on his purpose yet.
They keep saying not profitable, too small, too much thought, not marketable, and it doesn't follow trends, it's not targetable. And they won't listen to it, they won't listen to it. That's what they pitching me, but no, I'm never listening. It's all about positioning. Where there's a will, there's a way.
My mindset is to live this dream, so my grind time is 3:15. I'm in the right direction. I put my soul into molding these quotables, moving up on the totem pole, so why would you try to question what I'm destined to be? When I'm resurrecting these records and you can detect that there's no second guessing that I will wreck them soon. Yet they're neglecting to see my vicious perspective, objecting on my objectives. It's like they're hearing selective when they pick and choosing these hooligans, confusing music with nothing but foolishness, all because their contributions are lucrative. Now I could keep going about how they want the same shit, but all of that explaining and complaining ain't gonna change it. So either rant on YouTube with the pouting, or get up off your ass and do something about it. So I took that leap and soared on the people that kept me grounded, leaving dumbfounded stares on the faces of those who doubted. Now they astounded, I was never down with the cowardice. I counted every single encounter, exposing counterfeit. See, I refuse to let anyone try to condescend the message I deliver due to the fact they can't comprehend. I write my heart out till there's no ink in my fountain pen, just to change the culture's perspective and eyes of countless men. So just because they close the blinds with their scrutiny, doesn't mean I won't find a window of opportunity.
They keep saying not profitable, too small, too much thought, not marketable, and it doesn't follow trends, it's not targetable. And they won't listen to it, they won't listen to it. That's what they pitching me, but no, I'm never listening. It's all about positioning. Where there's a will, there's a way. Wait.